Hello everyone, from class 12 business studies in the chapter of directing, few of the topics that is meaning and characteristics of directing, importance of directing, we had already studied in our previous classes. Today we'll be discussing the elements of directing. As we all know, there are total 4 elements of directing, in which the first one is supervision, then motivation, leadership and communication. In today's video, we will discuss the first element of directing, that is supervision. So let us start with the meaning. If we will just bifurcate the word supervision in two, that is super and vision. So here, word super means over and above, and vision means to see. It means supervision means to see the workers while they are working from over and above, or in other words we can say observing the subordinates while they are working, and obviously guiding them, instructing them if they are making any sort of mistake or if they require any sort of guidance. So supervision refers to instructing, guiding and observing the subordinates at work to ensure that they are working as per plans and to help them in solving their work problems. So in simple words, if we'll talk about what does supervision means, supervision means observing the workers while they are working, and in case they are making any mistake, to guide them also. Let us move further. Now, supervision can be understood in two ways. First of all, obviously, as one of the element of directing, where it is an element of directing, so it has to be performed by each and every manager concerning to his respective subordinates. Every manager has to supervise to its subordinates. Every manager has to observe to its subordinates. As an element of directing, supervision is a function that has to be performed by each and every manager for its organization. While second point, that is supervision can be understood as one of the function performed by a supervisor. As we all know that supervisor is a particular post, and on that particular post the person appointed whatever functions he will perform can also be called as supervision. So as a supervisor, the functions performed by that particular person is known as supervision, or we can say that the guidance provided by the supervisor to his immediate subordinates or workers, that is supervision. And as an element of directing, supervision will become a pervasive function. Supervision will become a function to be performed by each and every manager. So these are the two concepts. Moving further with the second concept, that is supervision as the function to be performed by supervisor. So total we have 7 points that we can consider as the functions that a supervisor can perform. However, there can be other points also, but mainly the functions that has to be performed by a supervisor can be compiled in 7 main points. The first one is supervisor develops interpersonal contact with workers. Supervisor develops the good interpersonal relations, interpersonal contacts, good friendly or informal relations and contacts with the subordinates or with the workers, and it will really help the organization to bring a harmonious relation or to bring a harmonious discipline, harmonious environment, a cordial relation between the superior and subordinates. So the first function that a supervisor has to perform is that supervisor develops interpersonal relations or interpersonal contact with workers or subordinates. Secondly, supervisor act as a link between workers and management. As whatever instructions, whatever rules are made or given by the management has to be transferred, has to be communicated to the workers by the supervisor, and where the workers find any problems, any grievances, any difficulties, any change, that grievances are communicated through the supervisor to the management. So supervisor always acts as a link between the management and the workers. Whatever instructions management want to convey to the workers, it is conveyed through supervisor, and whatever grievances workers are facing, that are communicated to the management through supervisor. Supervisor acts as a link between the workers and management. After that, supervisor promotes group unity. What does supervisor actually do? Supervisor instructs the subordinates. Supervisor guides the subordinates. And in that scene, whatever instructions are provided by the supervisor, that same function has to be performed by each and every subordinate, each and every worker. In case there will be a lack of supervision, in case there will be no supervisor, in that situation it may be possible that all the workers in the organization may start working in their different manner, in their different fields, in their different understanding and interest power. But where the supervisor gives instructions, where the supervisor guides, where the supervisor supervises the subordinates, the workers, it brings the group unity and uniformity in the work performed by the workers. Fourth point, as the function of supervisor, supervisor ensures performance of work. Actually, it is the main function that has to be performed by a supervisor, that he has to ensure that the work should be performed. If any worker, any subordinate, any labor is sitting idle, is not working, wasting time, wasting resources, in all these situations the supervisor will guide him, instruct him and help him, and lastly ensures that the work should be performed by that subordinate, by that worker. So it is also one of the function, or you can say the main function of supervisor, that is supervisor ensures that his work will be, work should be performed, work shall be performed in the organization. Next is supervisor helps in providing training to the employees, because supervisor are in direct touch with the subordinates, with the employees, with the workers. So whatever new technology takes place, whatever change is required to be inculcated in the organization, the same could be easily brought in the organization with the help of training, and the supervisor plays the most crucial and important role in providing training to the workers. Sixth point is supervisor influences the workers. What does influences means? Influence means supervisor influence the workers through his behavior, through his positive behavior, through his workaholic behavior, through his personality, through his guidance power. The supervisor influences the workers. What does influence means? Influence means to put certain image in the eyes of the subordinates, to develop and build the image in the eyes of workers, that is called influence. And the influenced workers will definitely work willingly and with belongingness in the organization. The influenced and impressed workers will definitely work with greatest efficiency in the organization. As we can also understand it, as the second element of directing is motivation, and motivation completely depends upon the influencing power of supervisor. And the last one is supervisor helps to provide feedback. Whatever instructions have been given to the workers, whether they are understood by them clearly or not, whatever grievances they are facing, whatever problem they are facing, whether they can be conveyed to the management or not. This feedback is ensured by the supervisor. So these were the activities, these are the functions that a supervisor performs for his respective subordinates. And on the other part, as we had already studied, being one of the element of directing, supervision can be understood as the task of instructing, guiding and observing the subordinates while they are working, to see the workers from over and above while they are working, and to guide them if they make any mistakes. Being a element of directing, supervision is a function to be performed by each and every manager in the organization. But being a function performed by the supervisor, supervision includes these seven main points. I hope you all have understood all the points clearly. The next video lecture will be on the second element of directing, that is motivation. If you find the video useful, hit the like button and share the video to your other WhatsApp channels.